it's the best competition in the world. You know, we say that every time we come up against one another. To have, you know, two teams that can fight it out consistently, continuously, it's a credit to both countries, really, that in the standard of the game, I think we keep producing for the audience is really something special.
Norma Plummer, she's starting with a new attack line, although it still is very experienced, Julie.
I don't think you get more experience than Cox and McMahon. She's really flaunting her depth on attack, isn't she, Norma Plummer? And what I think this combination, though, will bring is slightly different to what we saw in the first test. The first test, we saw a lot of speed in that attack end. Won't see quite as much speed. We'll still see it, obviously, but what Cox brings is that height option, so we could see a bit more high ball going in, and they'll be stronger on the rebound.
Also, the fact that Kim Green has come into the wing attack position, her and Kath Cox do play together in the ANZ Championship. Now, the Australians adjusted better in that first test to the umpiring. Been plenty of talk about how loose the umpiring was, but ultimately they adjusted better.
Well, I think New Zealand can afford to muscle up a wee bit more. I think that's what the Aussies did. I think they adjusted to what the umpires were allowing them to do, and they muscled up. And I really think that we can be a wee bit more aggressive in that area if the umpiring allows it. You must adjust to the umpires. The one thing I will say, though, Jenny May, is when you do that, that you don't lose the skill factor from the game. That's an important one, and it is a fine line.
So a couple of changes to the Australian lineup. The scary thing is, Tony, is that they have plenty more options on the bench.
They certainly do. Such depth down that shooting end and the defensive end. I agree with Julie. I've had a lot of Kiwis come up to me this week and say, why don't they put the old elbow into those Aussies? So we will see if that's the plan for the Silver Ferns tonight. Stay with us. We have the starting seven right after this. Arena in Wellington for the Silver Ferns' second test against Australia. Now remember, they have to win this match if they want to stay in contention for the Constellation Cup. Now we haven't seen Danica Whippiete, Grace Rasmussen or Anna Scarlett against the Aussies this year so far. So will we see them in that starting seven? Bearing in mind that Ruth Aitken has said she wants to change things up a little. Let's take a look.
After getting shut out of the final quarter in test number one, no doubt Irene van Dijk will be wanting to bounce back in a big way starting at goal shoot, along with Maria Tutaia at goal attack. Moving to the midcourt, the experience of Temapata George will be vital at wing attack. Laura Langman starts at centre, and the ever-dominant Jolene Henry is at wing D. To the defensive end and Silver Ferns captain Casey Williams is at goal D, and a surprise move from Ruth Aitken. She has opted to give Anna Scarlett the start at goal keep for the first time since 2007. As we look to the bench, expect Liana Barrett-Chase to come on strongly once again. For coach Ruth Aitken, tonight's all about dealing with the pressure.
The thing about pressure, though, is it is really hard to have clarity of thought during that time. So it's easy for us to sit on the sideline and say you should do X, Y, and Z. But, you know, a team like Australia will put you under pressure. And, you know, we just have to rise above that.
Of her play that I hope have been tidied up. One is her bringing the ball out the defence end, and the other is just the control of her body. So it'll be interesting to see how she goes. It's been a while. She has played with Williams before, back in 2007, but it was the other way round. Williams was in the back, and Scarlett was out of goal defence.
Well, I guess we'll just have to wait and see what Scarlett can produce, but they've only made one change from that first test. But is it enough to reverse the result?
Well, Jenny May, we also have to remember that the Silver Ferns did stick with the Aussies for, what, 3.5 quarters, Kerry Wills, so it's not all bad from that first test. How do we avoid that final quarter meltdown?
Well, I think the talk about the umpires has overshadowed the fact that the defenders from Australia did some really good work and boxed in Irene van Dijk. Irene van Dijk needs to get off the baseline, use her footwork. She's got so much up her sleeve as an athlete that she just needs to work a little bit harder, a little bit more in that circle.
I'm surprised not to see Liana Barrett chase tonight. She did come on so well in that third quarter and made an impact. Is she an impact player now?
Well, I hope not, because she actually supplied the ball better to the shooters than what was happening prior to that. There's nothing like coming on after an anthem. That's where the pressure test really is for a player, and she'll want that.
When I spoke to Liana Barrett-Chase at training this week, she said she wasn't fazed when she came on against the Aussies from the ANZ Championships. She's had the confidence, so if she does get the chance, she'll be nailing it tonight.
I've been on the bench for a few years now, so definitely getting into that starting seven or just coming on as an impact, that's something that I've been really working hard at this year. And definitely to win gold medals, you know, that's something that's only a certain amount of people get to achieve, so I know we'd really love to add those to the collection. I think a bit of flair, a bit of speed, something different that I don't think has been seen in the fencing. I'm little and fast, and you know, a lot of people think, oh, you're short, how can you play netball and stuff like that? But no, I've just got to do my own job. And I love playing netball and I like doing little things that I do, so just bring those to the court. To win the gold medal, that's ultimate, to be on top of the world, you know, be the best in the world at your sport, and you know, you're in the record books, you know, you've got that gold medal around your neck. And I think for me it's all the hard work and time away from home really paid off, and you've got something to share with people that, you know, have never seen a gold medal before and stuff like that, so no, it's really exciting.
Team down courtside, Jords.
That's right, Tony. I can tell you that the loss on Saturday hurt us, not just the Silver Ferns, but us as a nation. You can see these girls are really going to step up the mark today in the game. Not only are the Australians trying to close this series out, but these girls, the Silver Ferns, are trying to stay in it. And tonight at the TSB Arena, it is on Julie Coney and Jenny May Coffin.
Yes, indeed it is. Jordan, the Constellation Cup is up for grabs. The Silver Ferns have to win tonight to keep the series alive and lock it up at 1-1 so we can head to Auckland, where everything is on the line. Also on the line tonight, though, are bragging rights heading into the Commonwealth Games, and also pride as well. But it'll be a great confidence boost for the Silver Ferns to come away with a win tonight as we wait for the teams to come out onto court. But this isn't actually a happy hunting ground for the Silver Ferns, Julie. We've met Australia here on 4 occasions. Australia has won all 4.
We're going to turn that around tonight, Jenny May. Here's hoping. Here in the capital, we'll have a change. A very experienced Australian side as they come on to court. I would have to say this would be arguably their strongest lineup. 320 caps between them, these players.
Well, it's quite a scary thought when you consider what they did in the first test. So plenty of options on the bench for coach Norma Plummer. Fairly lukewarm reception for the Australians here at TSB Bank Arena. And rightly so as well, as we wait for the Silver Ferns to take centre court.
Please welcome onto the court, your team, the Silver Ferns, goal shooter, Irene
quarter between the two of them. Irene van Dijk only got four attempts at goal, so they'll be wanting to change that tonight. 484 caps taking the court for the Silver Ferns.
Silver Ferns coach Ruth Aitken. And there she is, Anna Scarlett getting her start against Australia. So it'll be good to see what she's got heading into the Commonwealth Games. As we stand by for the national anthems, singing the New Zealand national anthem, Yulia, and the Australian anthem, Matthew Landreth.
Andrew Coppers and Joel Young-Strong, and the reserve umpires, Louise Travis. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the Australian Diamonds National Anthem to be sung by Matt Landreth. Gentlemen, please remain standing for the New Zealand national anthem to be sung this evening by Yulia.
Silver Ferns and Australia. The interesting thing about Wellington itself, the past two previous matches played in Wellington have ended with the score at 51-47. And there is our umpires for tonight's game. We have got Joel Young-Strong from Trinidad and Tobago on the right side. And backing her up tonight is Annie Kloppers, the South African umpire who was in control of the first test. We start to get things underway here. Rachel Green, 9 years old, is our ball carrier tonight. She has a congenital heart defect. So Great night for her. Let's see if it's a great night for the Silver Ferns as Tutaia gets things underway. George has to go back. Sherelle McMahon into things quickly. Joel Young-Strong into her job quickly as well. She was the umpire that officiated in Auckland when the Silver Ferns beat the Diamonds last year. So here's the speed coming out of the Australian end. McMahon finds Green. Cox tries to go that baseline. Scarlett has got it covered. As you said, Jenny May, these two know each other really well. Kimberly Green, the wing attack, feeding Cox. They play together for the Swifts.
I can't run with this. This year I'm going to slip.
Just the umpire calling timeout.
Yes, there's a cord that's just coming out under one of the hoardings, and the umpire's concerned she's going to slip on it. She's popped it in behind the hoardings. There we go. It's all tucked away.
So she's still not happy. We're still going to stand by and wait. Crowd's not happy. Just want to get on with things. Nat Von Berto has goes searching. Can't find anyone in the front line.
So in the first test, it was New Zealand that broke Australia's first centre pass. Tonight, it's Australia breaking New Zealand's.
That's right. The Silver Ferns got out to a great start in Adelaide. McMahon.
But they didn't have the finish, did they? And that was the undoing, the final quarter of the match. McMahon looking just as at home at goal attack as she did at goal shoot.
Henry. Langman finds Van Dijk way out of the circle. Tutaia was there. So George opted to go to the top of the circle. Van Dijk with a step in.
And that's the sort of thing I thought she would have learned from on in the last test, Jenny May, just stepping into that shot. The Aussies are all over it.
Yep. She was a bit off balance on that one, her landing foot.
And that's so important, and that's where Maria Tutaia is beautiful to watch. She's such a well-balanced and poised player on her shot. Sometimes Van Dijk just not quite ready for the shot, is she?
Looking for that long pass, a great defence effort from the Silver Ferns.
Unfortunately, it wasn't allowed to flow. No advantage was played on it.
Goat Langman with that intercept.
Contact centre.
Great to see the ball being delivered quickly tonight. In the first test, there was a lot of hesitation right from even the first quarter. There were players who had offered, like we saw there, Tutaia offering for the ball, and it wasn't given on the first in that first second.
Three seconds.
It's a very quick three.
Callanan on the run.
You don't mind if it's going to be consistent.
Von Berto, great balance.
Not so for McMahon as she slid along the floor. Great defence.
Yes, all the Silver Ferns kept their players away from the ball. It had to go over. So good work early from the defence.
That's better. Good split in that circle. Maria Tutaia at the top. So here's a intercept from Henry. Gift, really.
But it was good defence. There was no space for the attack to move into. They'd filled the space nicely. Something they got caught perhaps running a bit with the attack, the Australian attack in the first test.
We just see under the post, Irene van Dijk just doing a little bit more movement on Laura Geitz. Gets the rebound.
Continues to get away with that. We might see Furman come into the game a little bit earlier. Cox. George does well, but just goes offside, even though she was outside the court. It's the sort of full court pressure the Silver Ferns need. McMahon.
Oh, close to held.
Contact goalkeeper.
And that's the reach we know from Scarlett. She just needed to perhaps take her feet with her then, and she would have had that.
New Zealand.
Few early nerves from her, I'm sure.
Brilliant timing.
Well, it was a dangerous pass to make right across the circle and telegraphed.
There was only one place Maria Tutoia was going to pass that ball.
Australia, yes.
Australia, throw in.
Offside, free pass. Inside.
Good battle going on between
inside.
Green and Henry.
Yes.
Not sure these two actually like each other that much. Cox on the baseline. Makes the most of her opportunity on court. There's Norma Plummer standing up, doesn't want to sit down. Quite animated during this series, Norma Plummer.
Yes, the most I've seen from her, actually. Oh, lovely work. Plenty of space in there. Talking with her assistant coach, Nicole Kuzak, and selector.
Nicole Kuzak, of course, a former Aussie international.
Goal attack. Very handy goal attack at that. You would have played against her, I would have thought.
No, no, that's before my time. Oh, Julie, yes.
Sorry, it was probably me.
Tutoia again at the top of the circle. Long shot.
Yeah.
Does well. Got a handle.
I just feel like the availability inside the Silver Fern circle is much better tonight. They're getting free. They're doing some work. Good rotations.
Ring attack remains, please.
And down the other end, the Australian attack line is stuttering.
Well, I just think that the whole full court press or pressure from the Silver Ferns on defence is better in these early stages as well.
Great pass from McMahon. Green can't pick it up.
And great call from the South African Coppers picking it up.
Back to back on the circle edge. Yes.
Wants it taken in the correct place.
Williams finds Langman. Van Dijk does well. Just to pull the ball in. Sloppy delivery, but doesn't matter. George got it.
It makes me so nervous, that long pass, when it comes from above the head like that. He's always going around her ankles.
Great rebound position, Van Dijk. Tutoia, George, Van Dijk out. Yeah, Green gave Henry a bit of a push in the back.
I know it's early days, but we'll have a quick look at the shooting stats. And, you know, when the shots are low like this, there's glaring sort of differences, and it tells a story there. So New Zealand had a lot more attempts. And that's the only reason they're ahead on the scoreboard.
Yeah, misunderstanding between this Australian attacking line. Henry not happy with the call.
But when they get it in, they've been deadly. The 100% we saw on the screen maintained.
The Silver Ferns attacking line mixing things up a little bit. Sometimes Tutoia coming out the top, taking that top space. Van Dijk this time opting to take the top space. This is great pressure from the Silver Ferns.
And you see the rebounds there. So New Zealand's shooting stats well down, but they were getting their rebounds on attack.
Lomberto gave
Anna Scarlett a welcome to international netball. Anna Scarlett. So she's going to have to back off a little bit quicker.
Wow, Lomberto lucky not to be pulled for the contact, actually. Let's have a look at it. Yep, pushed into her as she was trying to retreat.
Yes, you've got to give the player time to get out of the way.
So it's really interesting having this new Trinidad and Tobago umpire on court, Joelle Young-Strong. The player's just trying to figure out what they can and can't get away with.
Well, and she's not letting these defenders get away with much at all.
No, she's not.
And it shows on the penalty count. Look at that, Australia. Double that of New Zealand in the penalty count. So they're coming from both ends against the Australians. And footwork now. So a lot of errors.
Great full court pressure from the Silver Ferns causing these turnovers.
Yes, that's what I was saying before. I think their attack are really quick to get on defence tonight, something that they were a bit sloppy with in the first test.
Great take from George and a beautiful pass.
It was a nice roll as well from Van Dijk. She lost sight of it for a minute. Just have a look at this. Her back completely to the ball. There it is. Yep, found it just on the baseline.
From the Silver Ferns early on in this match.
And they're feeding from the circle edge. They're getting on the circle edge, which is important.
And another mistake from Australia. What can the Ferns do with it? Yes. Much better speed and skill from the Silver Ferns. And Tutai rewards her teammates. And all of a sudden, they're out to a four-goal lead.
Well, they're getting the ball off the centre pass away as well. They're not going back all the time from the centre pass.
The other thing that's quite interesting as well is if you have a look at Williams and Henry, they're not crowding the transverse line. They're staying back behind the centre circle to give the attackers some room.
Well, George is having a lot more success off the line. She's taken four centre pass receives, so, you know, really, really getting in there for it tonight.
Oh, great work from Scarlett. She had Cox all tied up.
Because George had her work cut out against Hallinan in that first test. And I think Hallinan, you'd have to say, won that race. George is going to turn it around tonight.
McMahon, who's been fairly quiet so far in this match. Gerard, Cox is all the way out, but they don't want to give her the ball. Bonberto, McMahon, two defenders back.
That standing jump. Yep, the old volleyball elevation.
Problem is, they're not getting many rebounds because the Aussies are
accurate. Haven't missed. Cox, 7 from 7. McMahon, 2 from 2.
George, big pass into the corner to Tutaia, who didn't put her hands out to take it, thought that it was going to be touched by an Aussie, and again, there's that nice flick on from the Ferns.
Quick delivery, excellent, and also on circle edge, so no defender in front of her. Much better positioning outside and inside.
Big pass over the top of Williams. McMahon, steady as you like under the post.
Much more space in that Australian goal shooting circle on that occasion. They just moved, kept rolling till it opened up.
Oh, wow. Let off the hook, the Silver Ferns. It was the right idea.
There's a contact called on one of the Australian players, so the Silver Ferns got the ball back, and here they go on attack again. Cox. Interesting to see whether Norma Plummer makes any changes at the quarter break, or whether she says to her players, you get out there and you sort it out for another 15 minutes.
Yes.
But that flow from the first test certainly isn't there. Reluctant to turn and let the ball go. Cox, lovely shot from out wide.
Good ball movement from the Silver Ferns.
I think Maria Tutaia's movement's a lot more definite as well. She's a lot more decisive on her movement, and there's a bit more speed in behind it, a bit more, you know, passion.
Certainly all helps.
Out of court, the call. Bonberto finds Green. Both shooters running up.
Man ran into Cox. Yes, Yeah, certainly not the same space that there was in the first test in that shooting end. They combined and rolled the circle beautifully. These two players on top of each other a little bit.
George holds his space well at the top of the circle. Nice split between these two shooters. Gone back to the top. Tutahia along the baseline. Big pass.
Well, we haven't... In the first test, we saw very few of those passes. It's great to see that they're looking up court, the Silver Ferns.
And they finished it off with a long shot. So the Silver Ferns out to a great start against their nemesis, the Australian Diamonds. They lead by 5 goals, 16-11.
See you back for more action after the break.
Ferns out to a dynamic start here in Wellington. The score is 16-11. They lead by 5 goals. Jordan, looks like the Aussies have made one change. That nemesis, Susan Furman, is it?
Yes, that's right, Tony. One change.
So let's get this second quarter underway. Yep, Susan Furman onto the court. Laura Geitz gone to the bench as Scarlett goes hunting for the ball. And she goes to throw it in as well. The umpire says, sweetheart, back in the circle you go. Now it was on. Timing was just off slightly from Casey Williams, but an incorrect throw-in. Have a look at it.
Was our ball anyway, Jenny May. Diamonds hit it out.
Tutahia up top.
Oh, lucky not to get footwork on that occasion, I felt.
Callanan continues to hassle.
Contact, finger tap, fingers above.
So here we see Susan Furman, who gave Irene van Dijk a hard time in the fourth quarter of that first test. Restricting van Dijk to just 4 shots at goal.
Yes, it'll be interesting to see how she adjusts to her this evening. I felt she was very slow to adjust in that first test. She needs a little bit more movement, not movement out of the circle so much, but a little bit quicker movement in the circle, shorter, sharper. Off foot, Furman.
George has to go back to the transverse to find Henry. Lovely pass, good accuracy from Tutahia.
And Furman gets an arm to it, just stuck it in the air, back to the ball, did the damage.
Langman has to fight that space, fight for the space, but too quick from George to van Dijk.
Well, it looked like it could have gone to either. They were both in line, both shooters.
You could see that clash coming. Langman wasn't going to pull out. Helenan just gets back up, though, no problems. Von Bruto. Scarlett called for the hold.
Ball defense hold and both of you out.
Well, this is the end that we were talking about, the defensive penalties from the Trinidad and Tobago umpire.
And she's calling for that back, the back hand sort of coming out when you're defending, one hand up, one hand back. So the defense are going to have to adjust.
Yeah, great work. Lovely switch between Scarlett and Williams. And here they come out of this attack end like a bull at the gate.
That's great teamwork, great understanding between the two. And again, some really solid, sharp movement from the attack. And off the line, Tutahia looking like a completely different player. Bit of tuition from Belinda Colling this week. Was in helping the coaching team.
Brilliant pass from George, and we've got a held ball too. So not only have they been great on the attack, they've also been putting on plenty of defensive pressure.
Advantage contact!
Yeah. Nice pass from George and Tutahia. little dodge on the baseline.
Again, just not balanced. Taking that extra step on the shot, because you mentioned it before, she's coming off her base for the shot.
She leans in towards the post sometimes, Irene van Dijk, and she's capable of shooting, not doing that.
Absolutely. Again, strong off the line in the front. It's excellent work. And nice. Again, good feeding position.
Good pass and cutting between the mid-corners.
There's a whole lot of arms and legs in that pile up there.
Both players seeing the humorous side of it. You'll be all right, comes a call from Katrina Grant. Here it is, the two players jostling for space. Van Dijk sandwiched.
Von Berto and McMahon free on the baseline. Well, even though it was the attack line that was having some trouble in the first quarter for Australia, Norma Plummer opting to change her defensive end. Jolie Henry not really happy with the umpire. Williams, that's a great take.
She did extremely well because McMahon was almost holding on to her in that move.
Yeah, Pitaia had to push her way through there.
Well, we can see that aggression tonight from the Silver fans. Great to see.
Set move from Australia, overload.
Nice work, beautiful play.
McMahon, the skipper of this Australian diamond side, fairly quiet tonight. By her standards, anyhow.
Defending off court, goalkeeper.
Now, Furman called for defending out of court. You can't do that. Even though the shooter can go out of court, the defence can't. Don't like that rule.
Good rebound. Again, New Zealand have been really strong. Of the shots they've missed down there, they've tidied them up. Five attacking rebounds.
Bomberto, here goes McMahon, to Green.
And complete misunderstanding between Green and McMahon on that occasion.
Yeah, what's the chances Green's going to go to the bench?
I think probably pretty high at the moment.
Oh. Pass too big for George from Tutaia. Struggling through court, Australia. Cox has to come out and let them off the hook. But Williams is all over it. Good patience there from George. Stopped.
It's just great defensive work to get this ball down here for this shot. They really are slowing Australia down on attack, not allowing them to get that flow. And look what it's done. It's caused a timeout. That's a little positive sign for the Silver Ferns.
It's a victory. It's a victory for the Silver Ferns. When you look at the scoreboard, it is 24-14 in favour of the Silver Ferns. So at the moment, they are ripping this Australian side apart. Norma Plummer obviously won't be happy.
No, 8-3 in this quarter so far. So a very good start to the second quarter.
Well, if I was Natalie Medhurst, who's sitting on the bench, she started at goal attack for Australia in that first test, I'd be feeling pretty good about myself right now. And there's Geitz at the end of the bench. After 15 minutes, she was sent to the bench. As we take a look at the crowd and Ma'anonu coming along to support the Silver Ferns and also Steve Chu and Trevor Mallard just below him there. So we've got all the support out for the Silver Ferns tonight. They are certainly putting on a show for the fans here at TSB Arena in Wellington. Now let's see if they can keep the momentum going into this final 8 minutes.
And that's the key to it, Jenny May, to maintain the momentum. Good pressure over the ball from McMahon.
Tutaia just took her eye off the ball for that split second. McMahon, she's looking for that pass into the circle, but that defence is smothering at the moment. Anna Scarlett with her tall frame getting in their minds, and then Casey Williams is coming up with all the spoils at the moment. So well, Tutaia.
They're both so rangy, aren't they? And the work's been done up court for them as well. Both Langman and Henry. Have a look at this defence here. McMahon stranded with the ball and covered beautifully.
Well, it's a lolly scramble at the moment. Ball's going all over the place.
Nobody offering.
Like Williams' work rate tonight.
Yes, she's been strong on attack, bringing the ball through court. It's been opening them up with quick transition from defence to attack.
Gerard.
Nice long pass, good vision.
Cox will go for the long shot. She's not going to muck around with it.
Not afraid to put it up from distance, Cox. And of course, McMahon's always strong on the rebounds, even with her lack of height under there. She's just got immaculate timing. Helen and did well to get her hand to that. Not easy to be running back and go for the ball in flight. Well offside. That's a deliberate offside. I'd almost march it and give her a shot a bit closer.
Absolutely. She's 3 feet inside the circle.
It's deliberate.
George didn't want to give it one-on-one to Van Dijk. He has to go back to the top of the circle.
Yes, good timing. Nice pop. Took her feet with it.
Long shot from Van Dijk.
Haven't seen one of those for a while. Looked almost more comfortable on it than the close shot.
Cox up and over the arms of Williams and Scarlett. Yeah, shortening her distance, Anna Scarlett, within 3 feet.
Yeah, she had good distance to start, but just came within that 0.9 of a metre. Well, no way through there. Wrong option.
So, Furman and Van Dijk. Van Dijk.
And that's what we're talking about, that the small movements in the circle, much tidier tonight. We're seeing it all. We've seen the rolls, we've seen the dodge.
She's schooling the youngster, isn't she? Is he?
Yes.
I don't think we've seen Irene van Dijk have two substandard games in a row. And I'm talking substandard being her standard.
Yeah.
Australia's defence just holding the ball up slightly more for New Zealand.
Gerard called for the contact on George, so it's a 2-on-1 situation in the circle. Beautiful shot from Tutaia, has to step away from it. Scarlett following Cox all the way out. Williams goes hunting.
Great work, Jolene Henry there. She was covering the ball and she dropped off onto the cutting player. Held it up long enough for a help ball. Yes, so just filling the space enough that the Australians haven't got that nice clean air to drive into.
Tutaia has to step away again from Gerard's shot and nails it.
Wow. Wow, 13-6 this quarter so far, folks.
And Laura Langman called for not being totally in the centre circle again.
A niggly little silly rule. But rules are all 94%, so the Australians only the one miss. But New Zealand, so many more attempts at goal than that of Australia. They've been starved of shooting opportunity. Some great defence. Scarlett's come on tremendously. You wouldn't think that it's been 3 years. I think 2007 was the last time she played against Australia in an international.
And her combination with Casey Williams, their switches are really tight. So, you know, it's the first time in a while that they've had this kind of pressure against them.
Yeah, well, we've got some great options defensively, haven't we?
She almost comes up with an intercept. Then Cox, though, manages to pull it in. And the other thing about Scarlett, too, is she's come back into netball with a different attitude. She's been away playing volleyball, and she didn't realise how good she had it when she was playing netball. So she's got a different attitude. And she's loving every moment that she gets. And I'm sure she's relishing the opportunity to play against Cox.
Now, will this 10-goal lead give Ruth Aiken the confidence to look at a complete new line at the half?
Nice pop from George.
Yeah, I think, Julie, that this is the first time I've seen Maria Tutoia play this well. I'd like to see her stay on court and sustain it for a whole game.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I feel like at the moment the Silver Ferns attacking end is just dropping their intensity, so the break's going to come at a really handy time for them.
Long shot for McMahon. Well, I guess it depends what the coaches are looking for, whether they want to get all their players out on court or whether they want to consolidate. Nice split there from the two Australian shooters. And it's out of court call. Wasn't sure what the umpire was going to call then.
No, I wasn't sure whether it was the Silver Ferns out of court or Australia. It's the Ferns away with it again, though.
Henry does well to pluck that ball in.
George doing a power of work tonight as well. She is everywhere.
Tutoia again with that cut across the top of the circle.
Because it was the senior players that let us down, I felt, in that first test at times, and they're stepping up tonight, Julie.
Yep, they sure are.
Big pass from Tutoia. She would have known that the clock was ticking down.
Furman did it well with that away arm.
Wow, on the half-time buzzer, and the Scarlett comes up with an absolute ripper. The Silver Ferns are well in control of this test. After 30 minutes, they lead Australia 31-19. Can't wait for the second half.
Wellington, 31-19 the score is at halftime to the Silver Ferns. They have Australia in all sorts of trouble. They're struggling to bring the ball through court. They can't get any ball to their shooters. And our attacking end, the New Zealand attackers, Irene van Dijk and Maria Tutoia, are really hammering them. Julie, it must look good on the stats as well.
Yes, it's pretty good reading tonight, Tony. I think a couple of areas for me. The one that the fact that New Zealand's put up 15 more attempts at goal to that of Australia in the first instance. The fact that New Zealand have been right at the bottom of the page there, have been so strong off their centre pass. They've scored 20 of the 25. Australia only the 14. And also the turnover score. New Zealand there, of the 18 turnovers that Australia have made, New Zealand have scored off 14 of them. So New Zealand have been very, very secure with the ball.
Yes, very impressive. Also impressive tonight has been Irene van Dijk. She is our player in the spotlight. She's so far shot 88%, 15 from 17. 107 caps has the veteran. Tonight, a lot shorter and sharper are her movements. She forced Laura Geitz to the bench, and she isn't allowing her replacement, Susan Furman, to dominate at all. She is absolutely durable and accurate as well, and Irene van Dijk is having a ball tonight here at the TSB Arena.
We mentioned the attacking end really having a field day. What a turnaround from Adelaide. Belinda Colling is standing by with Jordan. She's been working with the Ferns this week. What's she done with them, Jordan?
Well, Belinda, that is the question. What have you done to them? They're playing awesome since Adelaide. That's the start we wanted.
Yeah, I'd like to take some credit. Unfortunately not. Outstanding start. To be up by 12 at halftime against Australia's, brilliant.
What do you think the difference is this week? Why are they beating them so well and convincingly?
Well, so far so good. I think, they just seem to come out there with a lot more urgency and prepared to go out there and do the work.
Seems like they've got some grit in there and they're just pretty much showing them no respect. Is that sort of the mentality?
I think there's a real belief out there with the girls, and like I said, I think that they're doing the work. They're prepared to work hard and just keep going and going, and that's what you need to do against Australia.
And Belinda, what would you like to see from the girls for the second half?
Just more of the same. Dig deep and don't let them off the hook. Put the foot down, really.
Put the foot down indeed. Cheers, Belinda.
Well, it certainly worked well in the first half. May it continue in the second half. Remember that fourth and final quarter was the doozy over in Adelaide. The score is here in Wellington at half time. Just a reminder, we've got another competition running. You can see that banner across the floor there. Shop, scratch and score. 4 grand prizes, 80,000 instant prizes. Get into your local New World and have a crack at that. Exciting times here at the TSB Bank Arena in Wellington. We've got some changes down there too, don't we, Jordan? No surprise.
No surprises. We have Danica Wapaiti on for Irene van Dijk there in the Silver Ferns, which is a big call by the coach of the Silver Ferns. And for the Australians, we've got Bully on at goal D and Nurse on at wing attack. Those are the changes.
It's not surprising, the changes that have come from Australia, but Danica Wapaiti, just after we've been talking Irene van Dijk up, at least she'll go to the bench happy. But Danica Wapaiti gets her chance to come onto court and to impress, and I can't wait to see what she can do. She's got those lovely rolls that she can do. So looking forward to seeing what she can do on court. And joining us courtside, in actual fact, is the Australian coach, Norma Plummer. Appreciate her time at the moment. Now, Norma, not the best first half from your team. What was the message at halftime?
Get into the game, basically.
Now, you made some changes here at halftime. Bullies come on. Were those forced changes or were they planned?
One's a bit of an iffy one, but the other is a forced one, yeah.
Which one's forced, Norma?
Sorry?
Which one is the forced change?
Kim Green.
Okay, so you weren't that happy with the way that she was tracking?
No, I just wanted a different move up. Okay. We need to open up the space. The Ferns, I thought, would come forward with their zone around the circle with the height, and we've played into that hands. I mean, this is good. At least we know what we're going to get at Comm Games. This is great.
Well, from my point of view, I'm really enjoying it, actually, Norma.
I bet you are.
I appreciate your time.
Hey, thank you.
So always great to have access to the coaches after the halftime break. Appreciate Norma Plummer's time. So at some stage we'll get to Ruth Aitken, hopefully, as we see these changes come into effect for Australia. McMahon gets a bit of a push from Anna Scarlett. Big pass over, but Casey Williams. So we had Norma Plummer just a few moments ago, and we're lucky enough to get down to the bench, to the Silver Ferns bench, to the coach, Ruth Aitken. Ruth, I'd hazard a guess and say that you're pretty happy with the way your girls have started. Ruth Aitken not quite ready just as yet, but we will get to her as the Silver Ferns force a turnover. Okay, let's try that again. Ruth, you'd be I'd hazard a guess to say that you're pretty happy with the way your team started.
Oh, yeah, I think it's been a great team effort, certainly, but it's not over yet.
What's particularly pleasing you, Ruth?
I just think our confidence on attack, we're really looking at trying to flip that ball into space and have, you know, just a real aggressive approach to our attack.
So I guess that buffer gave you the opportunity to put somebody like Danica onto the court?
Yeah, look, it's great. You know, she's got to settle in, obviously, but we need to have options going forward to Delhi, and yeah, it's awesome to be able to get her out there.
Well, what's the most important thing, Ruth? Is it the win during this Constellation Series, or is it the Prom Games?
Look, we are on the road to Delhi and we have to keep building there, but that doesn't mean that we're going to compromise the win at all. We want that with any players that we've got out there on court.
Love it. Appreciate your time, Ruth.
Wow, Whippy Eaty has come on well. 3 from 3 and they've all been long range.
The Silver Ferns with their tails up.
Just change the style in the shooting circle for the Silver Ferns. You'll see slightly different movement. Still got the height with Eaty, but tends to move a little more than Sundyke.
And there you saw Furman pleading for somebody to come forward so she could release the ball. Hellinen off balance. Yes, Williams, brilliant.
She came from way back up court too.
Oh, Bully shows she can get her timing bang on as well. Oh, she got a bit shove in the back from Tutahia too. She did eyeball Tutahia.
Here's the stunning intercept from Scarlett. She almost leaked from behind, from Williams, just about from the goal third.
Now contact called on Tutahia. Bully, again, struggling to find any options forward.
Been very impressed with the attack on defence tonight. It's really tightened up, really working well. Getting over the ball nice and early. Elevated ball, and Scarlett will go for it. She's a great aerial player.
She's a cool customer, as Cox. No problems for her.
Oh, the Aussies are cool customers under pressure.
Tamar Parrott-George did very well to get that ball. Natalie Von Berto just holding her hands down, getting underneath, getting over top of her.
Mabiti has to step back. Steady.
And that's the difference. We see Van Dijk stepping into the defence. Whippy Eaty prepared to step away from it.
Wow, Scarlett with a big step.
It was an advantage call, though. The umpire called advantage on it.
Left and goalkeeper.
Well, Anna Scarlett, she's got away with that. She knows it. Let's have a look. Couldn't find anybody. So another step.
Well, it's great to have an option in the back there, isn't it? Touring to Delhi, it's the sort of place where your team could go down quite quickly, so it's great to have options in all positions.
Cox. Scarlett doing very well to get around Cox.
Well, it's really interesting because Cox always gets quite low when she goes to take the ball, but because these two are so agile, they're actually getting around her. And so then she's having to do a little bit more work.
We talked earlier just about Scarlett's, you know, agility and the fact that she used to be a little clumsy at times, a little uncontrolled with her body, but I think she's doing extremely well tonight. Yeah, she has. Yeah. She's certainly coming around players nicely.
And speaking of that, Rebecca Bully does exactly that for Australia.
Yeah, Rebecca Bully had a great season for the New South Wales Swifts. It's good to see her on the court, actually. I think she's underrated a little bit because she's paired up with McClymer, but she does a lot of work.
Nice pocket by Von Berto.
What a great lane from Williams.
And great pressure and a Scarlett.
And I have to say, the defence have learnt. And Kloppers does allow the defence to be quite close on the lane.
So a lot of adjustments made, Julie, in the return of this test.
Yep, they've certainly learnt some lessons.
The BT has to step back again.
She's on fire.
Seven from seven. And they haven't looked like missing.
Henry does well, takes her feet to the ball. Can't quite tidy it up though, but Anna Scarlett's there.
Just the hesitation on the feed from Nurse. Cox had offered.
Plenty of pressure going on to these Australian shooters with that tall defensive lineup of Williams and Scarlett. Tutaia, nice pocket for George.
Ring attack, contact, penalty.
No, and George called for the contact. Random call, but anyway. Nice pass from McMahon to find Cox. So Australia just chipping away.
As they do.
And Scarlett gone looking again. Just
hands on the ball, Golden.
Timing off just slightly.
She might allow you to be a wee bit closer, but she certainly doesn't allow you to have your hand on the ball, Kloppers.
Great take from George.
She's back to her old self, isn't she, tonight? George, dynamic in the air.
Just quietly doing her job, really.
Not quietly.
With the odd brilliant thing put in there. Yeah, McMahon can't believe it from Kloppers.
Well, she's got such great timing. Good patience here from the Silver Ferns. Just lots of nice clearing out and repositioning.
Tutaia cramming George. Yes.
Tutaia. 17 from 22, 77%.
Well, if I was sitting on the sideline for the Silver Ferns, I'd be thinking, I'd be tapping my toes right now going, well, that's a big enough lead. Will they put me on? Will we see Grace Rasmussen? Yet to see her in this test series.
How did Denise Whippy come up with that ball?
There she is, Grace Rasmussen, Leanna Barrett-Chase, Leanna Dubray. Nice tap on from Cox to Von Berto.
I'm not sure we'll see another change in the shooting circle, but perhaps Barrett Chase on in the wing.
And speaking of that wing position, Lauren Nurse has come on at wing attack for Australia. Yeah, that pass is a little bit too big.
With Barrett Chase in the wing, it would be a lovely young front line, wouldn't it, for the Silver Ferns. And we've got a look to the future. Step. Oh, no, through a third.
Again, Mark can't believe it. She landed in that centre third.
Yes, the umpire deemed that her grounded foot was in the base third, so that meant it was the ball went through the mid third without being touched, which of course it must be touched in every third of the court.
Lovely little pass from George, and good timing from Tutaia, who walks away from the shot thinking it's going to go through. Whippy-Itty helps her out. Yeah, it's at speed from McMahon off that line, and then she's on the baseline. Nice square pass from George. Yep, Whippy-Itty was on.
Good again. Lane, good lane, but man, what a shot. Lane from Furman, superb. Win.
this time it's Wibiiti rolling the top of the circle. First miss, 10 from 11. She has come on extremely well, Wibiiti.
Yeah, I think Ruth said she needed to settle in. Well, no, she hasn't. She's in there mixing it up.
She had the luxury of sitting there having a look at it from the sideline for half the match. The Australian side certainly lacking the intensity that they had in Adelaide. But the Silver Ferns are certainly putting that pressure on them. Here's Scarlett with those long arms. Not allowing the Australian side to get into any rhythm whatsoever.
Well, the bounce pass is a slower delivery as well, and gave Scarlett time to get down for that.
George. Great take from George. That ball was coming no matter what. Tutaia, smooth.
Didn't even step in. She had the opportunity to do so, but no, beautifully poised and balanced. Lovely shot.
Bullet pass from Nurse, but a step from McMahon.
Another small victory for the Silver Ferns.
Yeah, I just heard somebody in the crowd behind me say, suck it up. Don't know if they're an Australian or a Kiwi.
Helen in good pressure over the 3 foot guard. Quick transition from her as well, from D to attack.
Advantage contact wing!
I think Lauren Nurse has definitely added something down this attacking end. She just seems to be more available to the ball.
Yeah, a little more height. Perhaps a little quicker as well.
Oh, that's the position where Norma Plummer was forced into making that change. In her words.
Advantage of contact. Contact in defense.
Frustration now on the faces of some of these Australian players. Hallinen called for the contact late.
Contact wing defense, where's the pass?
Scrap on the outside, Hallinen again in there. Nice.
Well, it was a lovely, yes, it was, wasn't it? Nice takeaway from Tutaia, moved away from the ball, opened the space for Wibiiti.
Good fast ball on the outside too, between the two middies, which is opening things up in that circle for the shooters.
Yep, just giving the shooters time to reset.
Bully, Cox, Nurse, nice fake pass, and a pop to the ball for McMahon. So the Silver Ferns well and truly in control of the second test.
Advantage contact on attack.
Question is now, will they leave it the same? Or will Ruth Aiken and Waimarama Tomonu look to give somebody on the bench an opportunity as we go into the final quarter with the Silver Ferns ahead 45-30.
Deflated there. The score is 45-30. The Silver Ferns well in control. And Jordan, I saw an awful lot of bib swapping over there.
Yes, we're just getting confirmation on the changes, but on for the Silver Ferns, Barrett Chase at wing attack, De Bruyne on at goal keep. We've got Green on at centre for the Australians and Prattley on at goal attack.
So, interesting changes. More for Australia than the Silver Ferns. Nice to see the Silver Ferns have forced Australia into making some changes and forced them into a mistake early on as well. So, Leanna De Bruyne on at goalkeep, and Leanna Barrett-Chase, who came into the first test incredibly well in Adelaide, gets a 15-minute burst here tonight. So good to see that. But perhaps, I don't know whether it's panic changes that have come into play here for Australia, but Susan Prattley has come into the game at goal attack. Sheryl McMahon, the captain, has gone to the bench.
Well, McMahon only shot 2 from 3 in that third quarter, although Cox did make herself a lot more available, 9 from 11.
And Nat Von Buto, she's gone to the bench, the centre. And Kim Green, who struggled at wing attack, has been brought on in her preferred position, which is at centre. So apart from Natalie Medhurst, the bench has been well and truly used for this Australian side.
Williams, yes, Cox and Helen are the only two in their starting positions.
So it's interesting, we talk about Australia having all these experienced players on the bench and wonderful options, but is it going to do them any favours come Delhi?
Well, you've got a theory on that, Jenny May. I can tell, I can feel a theory coming on.
It could perhaps count against them with so many changes. You want to get that continuity and the understanding.
Good hold, Langman, on the edge of the circle there. Helen and sitting on it.
When I was playing for the Steel with Whippy Eti, we nicknamed her Swish. That's why.
Well, you'd have to say that Scarlett came on very, very well in this test. I'm very impressed with the first three quarters from her.
Well, it's good to see that there's no momentum lost so far for the Silver Ferns, in particular down this attacking end, even though Barrett Chase has come on at wing attack and George, who was playing exceptionally well in a wing attack, haven't lost that momentum. Good work from Langman. Swung off her player, looking for a tip or an intercept. Nice jump pass from Leanna Barrett-Chase. Furman gets caught outside the circle, 2-on-1 with the ET. Long on the baseline. Puts too much on it.
In defense, you're not offside.
And Helen and Paul for offside. She can't believe it. Oh, he talked about Australia adjusting to the umpires better in Adelaide. They're certainly not doing that tonight.
Well, all those little things that went against the Silver Ferns in the first test are going against the Diamonds tonight.
Drop the goalkeeper.
Prattley on the board.
Nice swing from Barrett Chase.
Whippy Eti, quite a quiet mover in some ways, isn't she? She never seems rushed or flustered in her movement.
Yes, has been nicknamed Sneaky for a long time, and that's why she's so light on her feet.
There were some great switches going on between her and Williams. Well, you can't see it at the moment at home, but Grace Rasmussen has come off the bench and has gone out the back to warm up. So we could see a timeout, a tactical timeout, come here at some stage from the Silver Ferns and see Rasmussen come into the game for see what it's like to be playing Australian side. So
there she is in the background with Temapara George behind the bleachers.
one can only assume that she had come into that goal attack position with Liana Barrett-Chase only just coming into the game. Well done with the ET.
Well, this is a very young front line at the moment with Ripa-Yeti, Tutaia, Barrett-Chase, Langman. It's got a lovely fresh look about it. And holding their own.
And not that we're ageist, but Liana De Bruyne's really the only really older player out there. This is a really young side. Jolene Henry, she's been around for a while, but she is still quite young. So this is great for the future of the Silver Ferns.
Yes, Henry's just 27. I'm pleased you're saying that that's young.
Just a baby, Jules.
Nice roll.
Liana De Bruyne, 33.
Whippy Eti.
Tutaia.
Yeah. Tell there was a little bit too much on that one. Sneaky, sneaky, but she's incredibly poor for a step.
Oh. Well, we said that they needed to muscle up, the Silver Ferns. They've certainly done that tonight. They have won the first three quarters of this match so far. 16-11 in the first, 15-8 in the second, 14-11 in the third, and they're on track to take out this fourth quarter too if they can keep and maintain this momentum.
Barrett Chase, arms all over her.
Great vision from Captain Williams, straight into Tutaia, over the mess. This is great vision from the captain and a great take at the other end.
Wow, Cox was screaming for the ball on the baseline. Nurse wasn't looking.
They haven't been allowed to get their flow on attack, the Aussies, have they?
Not at all. It's been a massive defensive effort from the Silver Ferns.
What a turnaround from test one to test two.
Barrett Chase called for the contact. Petey almost comes up with it.
Australia really caught in exactly what the Silver Ferns were caught in the first test, just that hesitation on the delivery.
I think the reason there's hesitation is when Cox is coming out, the goalkeeper, whether it was Scarlett or De Bruyne, they're tracking her all the way out there, so they don't want to give the ball to her, and then they've got no other option to give to. They're so used to giving that ball to the running player. Lovely work from Prattley.
But great lean over her shot. Had to offload it. Well, didn't have to, but decided to. There we go. Rasmussen. Wait for it.
Maria Tutaia has called a timeout with 6 minutes and 16 seconds. And the bib is already on Grace Rasmussen as she gets a chance to show what she's got against Australia. So a wonderful opportunity for Rasmussen ahead of the Commonwealth Games. And of course we have the third and final test between the Silver Ferns and Australia from Vector Arena in Auckland on Sunday. Join us at 4 o'clock for live and exclusive coverage of that third and final test. And that test will decide who will take home the Constellation Cup. A roar goes up around the stadium for Grace Rasmussen.
Well, the scoreboard has certainly allowed this. I'm not sure it would have been a planned move, but because of the huge advantage in the scoreline, it's a great opportunity to get this young lady on court.
Just before then, Liana Barrett-Chase.
Look at the height difference.
Took a massive ball. Great balance, great strength.
If you have a look, Rasmussen, 1.77 against Furman, 1.96.
So let's just have a look at a look at this take from Barrett Chase. Just athletic. Nice fake from Prattley, good pop from Cox. Yes, timing better on that occasion for the Diamonds. Ever so slightly too close. Don't have much to say about that turnover. Yes, she's oh, sort of lovely from Green. Off balance, good core strength.
I think we can safely say that the Silver Ferns have got this match.
Well, hey, it's not very often that I feel comfortable to say that, and we're still four and a half minutes out.
Yeah. Rasmussen on the board now.
New Zealand have been superb this evening in a number of areas, and here's one of them, the intercepts. Casey Williams, 5 intercepts there, but a lot of that work has been done by the attack on defence, creating that ball for them, and you can see it's been reflected and picked up from the centre and wing defence positions as well. It just gets better.
Yeah, the Silver Ferns bench cheering on their teammate Grace Rasmussen. Bring up some lovely shots.
Oh, yeah, she is, and looking comfortable as well.
Yep, 2 from 2 for Rasmussen since she came on. 6 minutes to go in the final quarter. That's when she took the court.
Rasmussen.
Quick off the line as well, wasn't she?
Yep.
Doing a job.
Clash between the two centres.
Let's see what the two youngsters will do in here.
Yeah, Rasmussen does well. Entangles herself from Bully.
And a lovely delivery off to Whippy.
Is she in a better shooting position?
She's a smart cookie, Grace Rasmussen. And got lovely touch with the ball as well. Very skillful player.
Just not working for them tonight, is it?
Rasmussen doing well.
Just have to say the whole defence, sorry Jenny May, the whole defence area has just been, they've just filled the space and the pockets that Australia want to run into so well.
Rasmussen just pushed that shot a little bit too far. Oh, well done from Whippy Iti out of court. Barrett Chase trying to barge her way through.
The thing is that the Silver Ferns haven't just won every quarter, they've won every quarter quite convincingly. It's not just been one goal. In the second quarter, they won by 7.
Yeah, wonderful performance from the Silver Ferns tonight at TSB Arena.
And they've broken the hex, Jenny May.
That's right. 4 games they've played against the Australians here, and 4 times Australia has won. Not now, though. Silver Ferns have got one back.
And the last big win they had against this Australian side was a 16-goal win. 20 goals at the moment. Make that 19.
Well, the exciting thing about this is we are going to go to Auckland all tied up as Paul Williams dives into things.
Almost steals another one. Yes. She's already had 5 intercepts tonight.
And that's the most pleasing thing about the Silver Ferns' performance, is that they haven't allowed Australia any momentum to get any continuity whatsoever throughout this test. And it's also great to see this lady here getting a full game at wing defence. Jolene Henry.
Yes, you'd have to say they've been consistent, haven't they, the Silver Ferns? Something that they perhaps haven't had in the past, that consistency.
So it's all over here at TSB Arena. The Silver Ferns have pummeled Australia by 19 goals. They have broken the hoodoo here in Wellington. Their first win in 5 tests here in the capital. And the Silver Ferns will be well and truly pleased with their performance, beating Australia 59-40 and managing to get 11 of their players onto the court. So there'll be a bit of relief for the Silver Ferns squaring up this series, knowing that
now that's
all alive.
Yes, exactly, for that third test at Vector Arena. The Constellation Cup at stake.
And a dejected Australian side go to the bench. They tried absolutely everything tonight, but they weren't going to get anywhere near the Silver Ferns. And we'll go to Kerry Wills, who's sideline with Silver Ferns coach Ruth Aiken.
Well, Ruth, congratulations. What has been the key to the turnaround?
Oh, look, it's just confidence and believing in each other and letting that ball go. It was great to see.
Well, you know, Norma Plummer's made a lot of her depth and what rich picking she's got. You've certainly given her something to think about tonight.
Yeah, we were pleased to be able to get players out there and for them to experience that environment. But I thought it was a great team effort, both on attack and defence.
What can we expect looking forward to the test at Vector after tonight? Can you go up again?
Oh, look, we have to. We know Australia will come back. They're a very proud team, but we've still got more in us.
We're looking forward to seeing it. Thank you, Ruth.
Thank you.
Norma Plummer, very different test to the one we had in Adelaide. What happened out there tonight for your team?
I wouldn't say that we went backwards and thought it was going to be easy, because I've said all along there's going to be murder on the dance floor, and I thought it was, and I just felt that we just didn't get off the start, sort of set the pattern, went a bit too soft on the feed.
Do you think it was more a case of your players playing badly, or was the Ferns doubling their performance?
Oh, I think they lifted it up big time, but I expected that, you know. I mean, we knew all along Irene had come out for a blinder, because, you know, last week or Sunday, whenever it was, you know, she probably had let it slip, and this time we knew that she would come out. But this is the sort of game, at least you know where you're going to sit now before Commonwealth Games. So I can look at it and cry about it, or I can go on, well, now I've got it all there. I know what I'm looking at now.
And we know, Norma, that's not your style. Thank you for talking to us, and we will see you in Auckland.
Yeah, we certainly will. I think it'll be very interesting there. Thank you.
I'm sure it will be. Thank you, Norma Plummer. Very chipper. I'm sure she's got some more tricks up her sleeve, no doubt. But tonight belongs to the Silver Ferns. The final score, 59-40, and it's set up now for a big final in Auckland. The Silver Ferns have won here the second test at the TSB Bank Arena in Wellington. What an outstanding performance from many of the players. There can only be one player of the match, though, and tonight that is Temi Parra-George. She was simply outstanding. She was benched in the first test in Adelaide because Renee Hallinan sort of gave her a bit of trouble, but tonight she had no trouble at all. Beautiful feeds into the circle and really had that attacking end gelling, and she is with Jordan Vandermeid.
Well, Temi Parra, once again, player of the match, I'm here with you. What a difference a week can make.
Yeah, it was. We needed to redeem ourselves because we know we didn't put out our best, and it was just the basic areas, and I thought we controlled the game really well tonight.
For you out there, you really were moving well throughout the court, and you've sort of upped the ante even more, even if you could. For you personally, were you happy with your performance?
A lot better than what I played in the first test. I think, you know, I attacked the corners and I dominated, I think, through the court. But all of everybody stood up tonight and it was just a great feeling of connection out there on court.
The attitude was fantastic. No respect, you were just going out there and giving it to them. Hey, is it also good to break the hex of not beating the Australians here at TSB? Now you got one back on them?
Yeah, well, we didn't even think of that, but yeah, we did. We did break it and it's great to win against Australia, who's a classy side.
Well, Tim and Pata, now it's time to go win the silverware in Auckland on Sunday. So I hope you have a good couple of days and we'll see you in Auckland.
Awesome, thanks.
Yes, Timi Puttigieg, player of the match, but really there were a few options tonight. All of them played really well for the Silver Ferns. It has set up an incredible final match. And just remember, that is at Vector Arena, exclusively live here on TV1 from 4 p.m. on Sunday. Thank you for joining us here in Wellington. Don't go away, because This Is Not My Life is up next. Great show. I love watching it. I'll try and get there. See you in Auckland.
Thanks for watching tonight's match. See you at the next one.
All that I'm hearing from you is white noise. White noise.